and judgment on the land. You can't change that, sister. You can't change that. Because you have that unction from the Holy Ghost. You have that anointing. If you see things not going right in this house, you can change that. Tell somebody you can change that.
You can change that.
Come on, you can change that, Miss Mary. Glory to God. God said, if I shut up heaven, that there be no rain. Hallelujah. If I command the locusts to devour the land, or if I send pestilence among my people, if my people which are called by my name, are you called by the name of the Lord today? Hallelujah. If my people which are called by my name shall humble themselves and pray and seek my face, Lord have mercy. Listen up. To seek the face of the Lord is action. To seek the face of the Lord is effort. It is not just about talking, seeking now. It's about getting radical. Because anytime you talk about prayer, you must talk about war. If you talk about worship, you must talk about war. Prepare yourself for war when you decide to pray. Because there are going to be obstacles. The tides are going to rage. The billows are going to toss. Hallelujah. Things are going to happen to discourage and to disturb. When you talk about prayer, put on war clothes. When you talk about worship, put on war clothes. Hallelujah. Because the enemy that's going to roll over, and if you have the victory, you have to fight for it. I need a revival. I must be determined to trump it. I must be determined to get radical. I must be determined to lose myself. It could be some sleepless nights. Hallelujah. It could be some change that need to be impacted in somebody's life that I might have to take that wounded one. Hallelujah. And if I can't read such a one in my talk, I must read such a one in prayer. Somebody say push. Pray until something happens. That's what it means. Push. Pray until something happens. Push somebody. Hey, glory to God. So when God said, and seek my face. Seek my face. Seek. 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 Ladies, you know what it means. To search for something. You have to be patient sometimes. That even though you're angry and cussing and quarreling, you have to turn the place upside down. Turn over the bed, move the table. Nobody talk to me. You see, you let me look for this. So Jesus gave one of his parables. Hallelujah. And said, a woman lost a piece of coin. Hallelujah. She'll move heaven and earth, so to speak. To find it. Because ladies love money, not true. Ladies love money, not true. Yes, man. Yes, man. It is said that if you go to her bedside and she's well sick, and you want to know if she died and drop some money. If you see the head kind of, if you see the head kind of, if I say, is what that? But something has to be said. Yes, God ladies love money. So Jesus said to remove the whole place. She had more, you know. But my God, man, I want it lost. She didn't stop search and dig up the whole place. That's what it means, seek. You must stop until you find. Glory to God. So God said, if my people are called by my name, shall humble themselves, come in repentance, come in humility, cry out to God, seek after Him in your prayer, make some kind of petition, some supplications. Hallelujah. Give up yourself selflessly to the cause. He will hear from heaven. Forgive their sins. Turn back the famine. Turn back the drought. Turn back the hard times. Turn back the bad way of living. Turn back the contrary said Jesus. If my people shall call by my name. You have heard today whatsoever he told you to do. Yes, he told Solomon to tell. If my people, if I send locusts upon the land, if I don't cause no rain to fall, if you find yourself jobless, if you find yourself can't pay your bills, if you find yourself sick, and when it's not one condition, it's another. Hallelujah, not one situation, it's another. Prayer. Push. Can I hear the church say push? Can I hear the church say push? Ah, can you commit yourself? I'm going to push. P-U-S-H. Pray until something happens. Pray until something happens. Don't stop praying. Don't stop praying. Don't stop praying. It don't look good. It don't sound good. It don't feel good. I don't like it. This is not where we ought to be. But glory to glory to Jesus. Push somebody. Push. 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 Can there be an anointed prayer group in this assembly? Hallelujah. Who is willing to give of yourself selflessly, to live a clean life before Almighty God, to surround your pastor with prayer. Hallelujah. To surround the church with prayer when nobody else wants to pray. Amen. We use our phone for various different kind of reasons. Hallelujah. We don't use it many times for the right reason. Hallelujah. We want to use our phone for the right reason. To call up somebody. Do you have a minute? Do you have 2 minutes? Do you have 5 minutes? Hallelujah. Apart from the great prayer line you have. Glory to God. Go individual. Praise God sometimes. Distract somebody from that kind of mindset they have. Distract somebody from that kind of thought that they have. Praise God. There are many times I will give a call to somebody. Praise God. And they may never even tell me what later on I heard. That boy pastor, it couldn't be a better time you call. Amen. It couldn't be a better time. You changed my focus. Hallelujah. The things you said just touch my spirit in such a positive way. Hallelujah. Sometimes we need to do that as anointed people. Do you know that you're anointed and appointed not only to speak in tongues, not only to clap your hands and stamp your feet, not only to make some big shouts in church, but you're anointed to stand guard against the forces of darkness in this world. Do you know that if God allowed you to be in America, you are here to make a difference? Do you know if he put you at that position where you are living, that you are strategically positioned for a purpose? Do you know that if you are working in this area, praise God, you are strategically placed for a purpose? Do you know that if you are coming to church today, it's to be charged and recharged? Hallelujah. To take a stand for God. Somebody said, if only you and I, hallelujah, would get hot for God. Sinners would awake. The powers of hell would shake. Hallelujah. So why not then, for Jesus' sake, get hot for God? Get hot for God, somebody. Get hot for God. You can make a difference. You can fight some battles. You can conquer some foes. You can still some tempest. You can talk some storm. You can do it. Stop telling yourself, poor little me. You may never be named missionary, evangelist, hallelujah, elder, deacon. You may never be given the fancy titles. You may never even be privileged to sit on the choir. But from where you are at, hallelujah, you're anointed. And you're appointed to fill a gap pastor may never be able to. Or any other anointed worker. In closing, let me say to you, for whatever the challenge is, you're anointed for it. For whatever the work is, you're anointed for it. Don't stay where you are and criticize what the other person is doing and not doing. Hallelujah. Stand God and see to it that your purpose is fulfilled. Because you're carrying an anointing for a job that must be accomplished by you. God doesn't call idlers. And if he does call idlers, he called you to make you workers. The kingdom is too vast, church of the living God, for you to waste time. Hallelujah. And it is said, praise God, that if you find yourself in the kingdom and has nothing to do, you are just rendered useless. Rendered unemployed. Not able to be employed. Come on. Come on. Are you a vegetable? No, 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 no. You are not a vegetable. You are appointed for a task. So somebody said, do you pray unto God the Father? What will thou have me to do? Never fear. He will surely answer. There's a work to be done. There's a victory to be won. You have got the power. The God is not done. You have got the power. The God, the word done. You are anointed people of God. Do you know that if you pray, you will have the work accomplished? Do you know that if you develop a prayer life, God will minister to your spirit and let you know what he wants you to do? Do you know, praise God, that if you are determined to work, then God is more than determined to use you. You and you and you, and especially you. For you are not ordinary. You only sit there telling yourself you can't manage it. You can manage it through pride. You can do something for God. He has done so much for you. And is still doing so much for you. Right.